press the bell icon on our YouTube app and never miss another video from SpotboyE.
You talk about FanKind, people get a chance to meet their idols or celebrities they love. Who are you fan of? And you want to get that person on FanKind?
A lot of people.
One person top of your mind.
There is Ratan Tata, who I would love to have for an experience. Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor, Hrithik Roshan.
Please give dates. I've interviewed her brother Arjun Kapoor a lot many times since the time he debuted in 2012, but this is the first time I get to interview Anshula Kapoor, and I'm quite happy because it's thanks to her initiative FanKind. Anshula, first of all, thank you for talking to us.
Thank you for having me.
So let's begin with FanKind. Sure. What was the whole initiative? How did it, pop up in your head one fine day that, because it's a very different initiative where fans get to meet celebrities, because there is no structured way right now where fans get a chance to meet the celebrities, and you are providing that structured way to the fans.
It's a platform. FanKind is a platform. The idea actually came to me because of Arjun Bhaiya's fans, to be honest. Over the years, they've adopted me into their lives and into their families. I've become their extended circle. Because if you remember, when he first became an actor, he wasn't on social media.
Yes.
One of those rare few. And he came online, I think, 2 years into his career. So for the first 2 years, I was the conduit, or like the carrier pigeon messenger who was passing on positive messages, criticism, whatever it was, to him. So because
of that, you never filtered out. You used to tell him everything, the trolls.
Not everything. Okay. See, he's never like been trolled as such.
Yeah,
where, like,
that I agree. Yeah.
On my platform for me, anyone who's tweeting to me has never like gone out of their way to be nasty.
Mm-hmm.
Now what they do today's day and age is different, because now they directly can write to the actor. But to me, it used to be mostly like, there used to be these cute little aunties used to give criticism about like how he could have done one scene better, or those kind of things.
Aunties, please note.
Or they would stop me in a theater and be like, we saw his last photo shoot. He was wearing blue. Blue looks nice. Tell him in next movie to wear blue more.
Oh,
like
wow.
Stuff like that. Or like really sweet messages and things like that. So it eventually became a relationship where they made me feel, even though I am not an actor or a celebrity and they are not my fans to begin with, they made me feel like I am the queen of their world. They've named a star after me. I've had people send me home cooked food when I've commented saying that like I'm missing mom. I've had people send me videos of their mother praying and wishing for me when my health wasn't all that good. So it started off by me wanting to, the idea was I wanted to do something to give back to Arjun's fans who've been awesome through the journey, through all of both of our ups and downs, right? But then during Sonam's wedding time, I realized that fans are awesome, not just for Arjun, but like for everyone in my family. The amount of love that's been showered and all the positivity that they give should be amplified, so that anyone who spreads any kind of negativity doesn't have that kind of volume or reach.
Yeah.
And the people who are tweeting, writing, commenting, all they want is recognition. All they want is that you know who I am just because I've commented.
In fact, they're happy just with one reply that Arjun
one
gives,
reply,
one tweet,
or a like,
Sonam. Yeah,
or a
exactly.
like, or a view. It's not even like they require the earth from us.
Yeah.
And they come and see their movies, they appreciate them. So it is, I believe that a celebrity is as powerful as their fan base eventually.
Yeah.
So this was just my way of giving back to that community who's been so supportive of my entire family.
Yeah.
And why restrict myself to my family when we have the entire industry?
Correct.
And beyond Bollywood, I'm talking about the Southern industry, the Punjabi film industry, sportsmen. There's so many people that you can be a fan of. So that was a germination of the fan side of things. The kindness aspect actually comes from our mother. She was a big believer that whatever you do or whatever you receive, you need to be able to pass it forward as well, because you grow when everyone around you grows. It's not an isolated effort. So instead of starting our own NGO, there are so many amazing associations, organizations that do great work around the country. I thought that it would just be ideal for me to help fundraise for them, so that the burden of raising X amount of money for a campaign that they are so passionately making sure it's happening on the ground, on the on the ground can take place. So that was actually how Fan and Kind come together for FanKind.
So but then, you know, getting your first celebrity on board, and even before that, it's almost like, you know, you're making a film. The post-production, pre-production phase, tell us about that. That, you know, how many months or how much time did you put into actually organizing the first ever shoot or the meet?
Actually, the first step was to create a brand, right? So to create the brand, it started off by going to an agency and making sure I have my website in order, all of that in order. That process started last year in July. And then in December of last year is when I approached the first few celebrities. And in January, I believe, it was when I approached Varun that he was the first one to say yes. I met him in the hustle and bustle of meetings and fittings and narrations. He and his manager took out some time for me, and within a few minutes, he was on board. He wanted to do this because he genuinely loves his fans. He loves interacting with them. We've all seen him actually go out of his way. So he was sold on that side of the things, and he has wanted to do something to help farmers in Maharashtra in a real holistic way, not just a one-time handout kind of a situation. So that's actually how FanKind for him became that platform that could enable him to fulfill his wish by also fulfilling a fan's wish. So it was...
it's a win-win situation.
That's the way we look at it. It is a win-win situation. But that was the first person to say yes. It just so happened that I met Alia the same week, and I was so nervous. So I was like, I've met Alia before, but I don't know why, when I met her to kind of pitch FanKind to her, I couldn't stop shaking.
But you have like almost seen each other growing up.
No, we've not grown up together.
I mean, but you guys know of each other.
She has worked with Arjun,
so
therefore I've spent time with her during the making of Two States. And obviously, socially, we have interacted. But social and personal is always different from work. And it has to be, that way. This meeting was with her management present and all of that as well.
So entire team of Alia.
Same with Varun. Because at the end of the day, it is a business venture, right? And I need
their brand
and I need
also.
Time from them. Yeah. And if I need time from them, I need them. I need the entire ecosystem to be present and to know that this is what's being taken forward. Because FanKind at the end of the day is any other brand. The difference being there is a charity angle to it, and that I require their time on two separate deals. One is when we do the marketing shoot, and one is when the actual fan meet and greet happens.
I want to ask you that, you know, of course, from an outsider's point of view, everybody sees entire Kapoor family as, you know, oh, they're, I mean, they're Bollywood, they have it all. But then here you are associating yourself with all these charities and doing meaningful work. Has it changed your perspective about a lot of things personally for you, you know, when you see such victims, when you see charities, what people are working for? Has it changed your perspective over this 1 year when you're actually working on it one-on-one now?
That's a great question. I've been fortunate enough to actually have worked with NGOs and charities through my life. Started from when I was in 8th standard, the first time my mom actually made me crowdfund for a good cause. At that point, it was because there was an animal that needed surgery, and I felt really bad that, like, it was a street dog. And there, I'm talking about in the like late 90s, early 2000s, there weren't so many organizations that took care of animals that have been injured through a hit and run, etc. And I wanted, and I was petrified of dogs at that point, but I still wanted to help.
You petrified of dogs?
Oh my God, I was
stories.
Petrified of dogs at that point.
I mean, right now, you can't live without your dog.
I can't live without Max. Max is...
he has more prominence on your Instagram as compared to any of your family members.
That is 100% true. But at that point, I just wanted to help that animal get a chance to live his life.
Correct.
So my mom said, okay, great. What are you going to do about it? I therefore sold chocolate candy and calendars to get money to do a surgery for this animal. So that was
when
my
first.
When
you were in 8th standard?
It was in 8th standard. We lived in a compound where there were a row of bungalows and a building.
Okay.
So I've knocked on every apartment asking them for money, and I've sold them calendars in return for that, because I found out that PETA gives you calendars to sell to raise money.
Okay.
So, I don't think I told PETA that I'm raising money for a particular animal. I just took their calendars.
I'm selling your calendar.
So that was actually how my journey started. And through then, to now, I've always tried to associate my time or monetarily with any kind of cause that speaks true to me, whether it's a cause about women empowerment or it's a cause about helping cancer patients or family members of cancer patients or cancer survivors in that sense as well. So, what FanKind, coming back to your question, sorry, I'm a rambler.
No, no, that's okay. It's okay, completely.
Coming back to your question, working hands-on with our philanthropy partner, which is Give India, for NGOs because of FanKind, has opened my perspective to causes that I would never have thought needed our attention.
Correct.
Because we live our lives and attach ourselves to causes that are really personal. So, for example, if I've lost my mother to cancer, I know for a fact that is always, that cause is always going to have a soft spot for me. But there are so many other wonderful NGOs doing so many different kinds of positive things in this country, in this world, whether it's for mental health, whether it's to help farmers, whether it's for animals, whether wild animals, pets, etc. That, like, it's helped me realize the breadth of how much we as a society have to do to give back. So in that sense, I'm a lot more hands-on beyond the two causes that have been like my passion causes in that sense. But I wouldn't say that I have been oblivious to this world before FanKind. It's just made me a lot more driven to ensure that I can do everything in my capacity to grow FanKind so we can raise more money for these charities and to also associate with different kinds of charities through the months and years that we are alive. I'm hoping that's forever.
So, you know, you talk about FanKind, people get a chance to meet their idols or celebrities they love. Who are you fan of? And you want to get that person on FanKind?
A lot of people.
One person top of your mind.
No, a lot of people. I can't just name one person. I'm going to give you like a list and then you have to tell me to keep quiet because it's an unending list. If you're talking about celebrities from India, it would...
Oh, there's Hollywood also involved.
Why
not?
There is Ratan Tata, who I would love to have for an experience. Priyanka Chopra, Ranbir Kapoor, Hrithik Roshan.
Please give dates.
Adam Levine, Maroon 5, obsessed. Michelle Obama, obsessed.
Oh, Michelle Obama, please. I am going to message you if you get Michelle Obama, that I want to meet her.
I may just declare myself the winner of that experience.
Nobody comes on board, I am shooting this video.
And Karan was also part of that list because I am a huge admirer of his work, of him as a human, and also of, I think, about just about everything that he does. So the when he said yes, I've told Arjun Bhaiya, I think, 7 times. Did you know Karan said yes to FanKind? Arjun Bhaiya was like, I know.
You've told me already.
Yeah, like, you, as soon as you sat in the car, you called me saying, oh my God, Karan said yes. I know he said yes. She's like, no, but Karan said yes.
So, you know, you talk about Arjun. I mean, he talks about you fondly on your Instagram posts and everything. But when I asked him that, you know, I would love to do an interview with him and you, he said, no, it is Anshula's time to be in the limelight and I won't be taking any of that. So it's a very great thought because every other sibling or, you know, a spouse, whoever's launching anything, the other person is always there to promote it, the project. But here, Arjun has given you the spotlight and it's a pleasant change, actually. So what do you think of that?
He is, he's very sweet. Of course, he supports me. I mean, he posts about us all the time on his social media and he is very vocal and supportive. But he's seen me work on FanKind on my own and he wants me to own it because he believes that the, like you said, the passion with which I talk about it, I deserve to talk about it without anything distracting me from it. But of course, we will be talking about it together as well because especially when we do an experience with him, I would love for us to go out and like talk about it together because it would never have been possible had it not been for him and his fans and just his support even beyond if I leave him as an actor aside and just keep him in mind as my family, FanKind would not exist had it not been for him. So, and I know that I can wake up every morning and concentrate 100% on FanKind because I have his support. So at this point, he may have wanted me to, and also this is me going out of my comfort zone. So I think he would want me to do this on my own before like hand-holding
me
through
it.
He'll
take time. But yeah. she will talk. And
you
yeah,
messaged me in August when we launched.
And it's December. And I told you
that please give me some time. Because
so it took 4 months for Anshula to make up her mind to come on camera.
No, make up my mind to just mentally prepare myself that I have to go beyond doing phone and personal interviews and go in print. I have to apparently now be on camera also.
Yes.
I thought if I'm not an actor, I can get away with it.
Great thought. But if you're getting into this, so of course. But then, you know, talking about Arjun, we've always seen a very warm bond which both of you have. And it's very evident. You guys don't shy from, you know, posting things about each other.
See, we talk more of our about our emotions on social media than we do in person. Because
that
we,
I don't
we
know.
Are so busy that we barely get
to spend
time
with
each other.
That, you know, before he debuted, of course, you used to see a lot more of him.
Yeah.
But in these seven years, I think 2012.
7 years,
I'm sure you see a lot less of him now. So
I travel to where he is now when I need to see him because I'm like, mahina ho gaya.
So how has your bond changed and dynamics changed, you know, for both you brother and sister?
Our bond and dynamic hasn't changed. It's just become, I was a child. I was barely 21 when he became an actor. He was a child himself. We just faced the biggest loss any child can ever face in their lives. When I graduated, he started his career. That obviously brought us closer because now we live alone. It's just him and I and our dog, Max. We live together. Cannot forget because it's Max's house.
Yes.
We just live in it.
Oh, wow.
we're emotionally a lot more in sync. If I have, if I need to just bounce off ideas, if I need to just vent, if I need to talk things through to process it, he's around and it goes both ways in that sense. If there is any kind of decision I need to take for FanKind, because he has experience in the industry, whether it's from the production promotion side of things or actually like talking to an artist, how do you be respectful of that and how do you not let your personal equation come in between? Because this is a brand, it is professional and it has to be such. You cannot take advantage of people in that sense. So those are the kind of things that he helps me with day in and day out. And it's just, we have grown up as adults, we've come into our own, we've had to become adults maybe sooner than we would have liked. Because of that, we've managed to lean on each other while not losing our individuality, and I would give that credit to him, because it would have been really easy for him to mollycoddle me and parent me like a helicopter parent at that point, but he chose to let me breathe and I chose to give him his space as well. So we've evolved as individuals and our relationship changes on a day-to-day basis. Because we live alone, sometimes I am his parent, sometimes he is my parent. Sometimes we're just siblings hanging out. Sometimes we're best friends, just like watching a movie. Sometimes we're getting upset over small things and making up because Max has just done something funny and we're both laughing. So it's a lovely equation and I wouldn't have it any other way.
Yeah, but then, you know, you belong to a family who has always been in spotlight and always been in limelight, and more so in the past 4 years or so, the paparazzi culture.
The paparazzi culture has
increased so much.
Yes, that
so,
has. That before that, I was even up until 2015 or so, till like the paparazzi culture didn't become what it is like today, I was relatively unknown. So my family could have been in the limelight, but you...
So the actors were always in spotlight, but you know, so how is it, is it difficult for you? Do you also go through the same process of, you know, should I wear this? I'm going to step out now. I will be... No, because every actor thinks that way now. Because they say it on camera. They say, it also that we think about, you know, what to wear even when we are stepping... I'm going out to the airport also now.
As a girl, you think about what you're wearing anyway, but I have not, I am fortunate and I don't want to jinx this, please. I don't get papped, like they say, if I'm on my own. And if you really nicely request them to not take a photo, they actually listen to you.
Yes,
so every time I request them to not take a photo, they really, really sweetly don't take a photo. Unless it's a public event at which they don't have an option, and then I...
you have to pose at the red carpet.
Sometimes I run away, but sometimes I actually do pose for them. And a lot
is
of them make fun.
Is that very awkward for you, that you just...
I am camera shy. I don't like photos. I don't like the camera. I start getting nervous jitters. I start sweating like a crazy
human. It's completely opposite to the space and the life you I mean, or the family you were in. I mean, I'm
not an actor for a lot of reasons, but this is one of them. So I always believe that my work should speak louder than my personal life, because now I have FanKind, I have a platform to talk about it. So I would like to take advantage and give FanKind that attention as opposed to giving myself that attention. I suppose if I was an artist of any kind, or if I had dabbled in any kind of in front of camera vocation, whether it was like, I don't know, anything, I would have received a lot more attention. But I can get by like just hiding. So I do that very nicely, and
but
I love it.
Somewhere that you were part of plays while, you know, in school
and colleges.
So
then
but
again,
never thought
this is,
of getting into no. Bollywood as actor or anything.
My dear darling mother had a great idea one day when I was in 9th standard. I had stage fright. So through 7th and 8th, every time I would enroll myself in a school competition, I would go on stage and freeze. Freeze to the extent of not even say a line of what I was meant to say. Stare blankly at everyone, but be on stage for my designated 3 minutes and then walk off. So she was like, you cannot do this. Because I was in a, as a child, I couldn't even talk if there were more than three people in a room. So she was like, there's a subject in, and I changed schools in 9th standard. The new school had a subject called theatre arts. So she was like, I am pushing you to take it because it's for 2 years, it's for 9th and 10th, take it. Get out of your shell, learn to talk to more than three people at a time. Perhaps learn to address an audience, because in 11th and 12th or later in life, if you take a job, you will have to give a presentation and address a crowd. You need to learn to be able to do that now. Therefore, theatre was a subject for me through 9th, 10th. And then I loved it so much. The first time I performed on stage was for a play called Midsummer Night's Dream in 9th grade. And I actually got like a standing ovation kind of a thing for it. And just the ability to be able to perform on stage and the amount of fun that we had putting it together made me take it as another subject in 11th and 12th. But I left it at that.
But that standing ovation never made you feel that maybe in life, future, you could pursue.
Even in college, I didn't do theater. I mean, and I went, Columbia has a lot of clubs that you can perform on stage with, but I chose not to because it was a subject. I mean, for me, theatre was as good as geography, math or science. It was a subject.
Coming from the Kapoor family, theatre was just a subject.
It was, it doesn't matter, right? Not every doctor's son becomes a doctor. So not every person in my family, like Ria is not an actor.
But she's a director. I mean, she's
I'm
a
part
producer.
Of the entertainment industry
correct.
Through FanKind. But I'm spinning it to suit what makes me happy. I don't have to be an actor to find happiness.
Wow, that's a very nice, catchy line.
I hope that's please don't keep that. I think that's like an, I don't know.
That
I don't
be
need
a promo
any
line also for us.
I don't need any. It's just like I.
She has said it and she's also rejected it. Please don't use.
I retract.
So you know, when you talk about social media, when you talk about the limelight on you and Arjun and your family, package deal is the trolls. You say that, and I read a lot of people, they say, and they call you Anshula Didi, lovingly, and there are times you just abuse that, why? But then, you know, there are a lot of trolls that are directed towards Arjun, towards...
Even towards me.
You also. So how do you deal with that? There are a lot of nonsense that goes out on social media.
For every 5 negative comments, there will be 10 positive comments. I read everything. I choose to respond.
Everything.
I mean, if I have the time and I'm scrolling through, I read it. I never report comments unless you have said an abusive word in any language that I understand. Then I will report you and I will tell you that I'm reporting you and then report it. But again, Arjun's fans, superhumans, all of them, they report comments, they report accounts, they fight my battles. They reply to everyone who's spreading negativity and then they'll send me a DM saying, I hope you don't feel bad, don't listen to what
sweet.
They have said, we love you. And so I'm like, you're
that's
a really,
sweet.
Really, really
yeah.
sweet, but don't worry. I have the one thing being part of this family has taught me is you must be thick-skinned. Arjun is thick-skinned and he's made me be thick-skinned as well. That's the only way to deal with trolls, because if you give them, if you fan the negativity, it just becomes a bigger fire. Which is actually another thing that FanKind will help spread that positivity as opposed to the trolls, because you don't give them space, they don't have amplification or volume.
Correct.
So if you,
So another thing that, you know, we all keep seeing is a lot of banter that goes around with not only you and Arjun, with of course Khushi and Janhvi. That day I think I only picked up that story and got it done on SpotBoy, the WhatsApp group chat that you shared on Insta stories. So it's really amusing and fun that, you know, you guys don't mind sharing the dirtiest pictures of yours, the childhood pictures that people normally don't share. I mean, I don't look at my pictures and share it on social media. But four of you, the equation is amazing. And how is the whole bond in the equation with Janhvi and Khushi evolved? And, you know, I mean, now Khushi is, of course, in New York. So
Khushi's in
you
New York.
Don't see much of...
Since September. So I haven't seen her since September. And Janhvi is living her best life as an actor set to set. She's completed 3 films already. She is just from one city to the other. But we try and make time for each other when we are all in Bombay. I mean, we share a meal together as often as we can, or just like as girls would do, we hang out and like watch TV. Or just the Kapoor family has a lot of food-related activities. We just meet for dinners and lunches because we all love food beyond measure. So a lot of our social activities take place around food. The menu is as important as who you're meeting.
Oh, wow.
It is just always pre-decided. Specifically if it's us cousins meeting, because we also have a cousins group that we plan...
Not many WhatsApp groups to
meals.
Handle.
We just plan meals on that group, and those meals happen to turn into hangout situations for us. But we have a great equation. Yeah, the age difference between the four of us it's a mixed bundle. Like Arjun Bhaiya is obviously the oldest, and then there's me, then there's Janhvi, and then there's Khushi. So sometimes it is us just 3 girls hanging out together, or the 4 of us just hanging out, kicking back, making fun of one another. Sometimes it's us giving us opinion. And because we're so much older, it becomes, it could be construed as advice, or it becomes advice. So sometimes it actually is advice in that sense as well. So it's great, yeah. I really enjoy hanging out with them. And they are great girls. A lot of fun for me to like just relax and get out of work zone by just like, even one conversation with Janhvi just makes me feel like, okay, like I can now get on with my life, because a dose of fun or a dose of like love has kind of come my way. Yeah, even like in the middle of a hectic schedule, she'll send me a message saying, miss you, yeah. Or like I'll send her like a heart emoji because she just thought, crossed my mind. Mm-hmm. And then we'll start bantering, and then we'll send like the worst photos of each other to each other and just have fun and like laugh. And I love it because now I have more than Arjun Bhaiya to like go to and do these things with.
Correct.
It's great.
And also, we've always heard from Arjun and Janhvi, I think, because they talk to the media a lot, that your father's favorite is Khushi Kapoor.
It's a proven fact.
It's a proven
fact.
But why do you guys,
fact.
3 of you, say that it's Khushi?
If you ask Dad, he will also say it's Khushi.
Achha, he admits it.
Yeah, he has very nicely admitted it to us.
Doesn't care what are the other
things.
No,
like,
things.
See, she's studying in New York. His heart is in New York, so obviously went to
went with her
to drop her, but he's gone to New York to spend his birthday with her as well in November. So,
okay.
Yeah, so he's very very fond of her. Also, she's the youngest, right? The youngest is always I've heard the youngest is always closest to the heart. So she does have him wrapped around her fingers, and he loves all of us. But he will go to any extent for Khushi, because that is a whole different kind of awesome love that he has. So yeah, but he is, it's like we make fun, it started off with us making fun of him that Khushi's our favorite child. But but now he has also just come out with it and said, but true hai, matlab chupane ki kya baat hai, aapko to pata hi hai.
So don't expect anything else from me.
No, but it's not like his love for us is labor. It's just... Hum teen hai aur Khushi is. Yeah.
So the other thing also, one person actually on social media had written that the Kapoor family is a perfect fit for Keeping Up with the Kardashians. That if you have to have an Indian remake of that, Kapoor family will fit best Keeping Up with the Kapoors. That person actually gave that name also. Do you think it'll be really cool to have a Keeping Up with the Kapoors?
No. I mean, it probably would be cool, but like, I like the fact that...
I mean, from content point of view,
I don't know, like, from, I mean, we're a bunch of fun.
Exactly.
We're like a group of fun Punjabis who love food. But I would, so much of our life is already out there. I wouldn't want our houses
inside, yeah,
and like our private time to be public. And also, I am so scared of the camera. If I had to live my entire life with a camera
somebody
around
following
me,
you.
I would probably
be fainting inside your house.
I would be a living, talking, breathing panic attack on a 365 day panic attack situation. I can't, no, please, no, please, no.
Look at your face. Yeah. I thought also. Okay, so I'll wrap up this interview. So Panipat is releasing. Have you seen the film? You got a chance to, you know, see the special.
I will see it this week.
Okay, so but then what are your thoughts? Because this is the first time he's doing a period film, and we've never seen him in that.
Yes,
avatar,
I've also never
so,
seen him
yeah.
in this avatar, and I'm very excited because Ashu sir is known to mount his movies beautifully.
Yes.
I mean, anytime Jodha Akbar still plays on TV, I have to catch it. It is the most beautiful piece of art.
Yeah.
So I'm very excited to see the film for the film, because I believe from the gist that I was told that it's a story that needs to be put out there as well. And I'm actually very excited to see a period film with Arjun Bhaiya in it, because it's so different from everything else I've seen him do. That it is just going to be really interesting watching the movie for all that it is meant to be, and the trailer was spectacular.
Yeah,
and,
yeah, it's amazing.
The
whole grandeur of the whole
yeah,
thing. Yeah,
even the songs, like the way whatever has been put out so far, everything is just looking exceptional. So I'm very excited to kind of watch it, and I'm hoping that I'm able to watch it because I have a migraine. That has not left me in weeks and weeks and weeks, but I will still watch the movie even through the.
Are you a harsh critic of Arjun? If you don't like one of his films or his role, do you tell him straightforward?
I mean, I wouldn't say I'm a harsh critic, I'm honest, because every sibling is honest with one another, right?
Yeah.
So I'm honest. If he asks me something, I'm very honest about it. Sometimes he may find that annoying where I'm concerned, but it's
you don't shy away from telling.
No, if my opinion is asked for, I give him my honest opinion. Mm-hmm. I don't consider myself a critic. I don't watch his movies or any of my family members' movies as a critic to be like, bahar aake ye bolna chahiye. Like, no, I'm watching it as an audience member, because I'm not a filmmaker by profession. So when I watch a movie, I enjoy it like how you would, or like any other audience
Correct.
Member would, right? So yeah, I don't think I'm a harsh critic. I'm an honest sister.
Fine. On that note, thank you so much, Anshula. It was really fun talking to you. You're not at all uncomfortable in front
Thank
of the camera
you.
The way you
forgive me if I have said something that I was not meant to say.
It was completely a breeze talking to you, and all the best for FanKind.
Thank
and,
you so much.
We hope to see all the wish list of the actors that you just told be part
and
of
And lots
FanKind.
More, lots
yes.
more, lots
yes.
more, lots more.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.